into an F smash. That helps a lot of things. But we're not speaking no more about Wii Fit. And, you know, Rob.
Now we have Kazuya Mishima and Samus.
And Salazar.
Now, I have not heard of this person before.
I think they're from Jersey because I remember seeing them playing Pac-Man, if I remember correctly, from DNA, which is something you guys should also check out.
Yeah.
But for sure, we're already seeing some amazing advantage from Salazar. Just amazing neutral, just playing the game, you know, doing Samus things. But, you know, what can you do if you're Kazuya and you're a...
And we so the thing is with the Samus matchup, especially if you're not familiar with it, is something it's really one of those we don't have any in New York sort of deals, so it can be really tough if you don't know this matchup. And Dark Blue is very, very solid player. Missing Electric Wing got fist. Okay, that's a huge combo coming out, 95%.
Are we gonna see a death? Not really.
Looking for that reflector though. Nice bait out by Salazar though. Okay, big parry. We're dead.
There. All right. I was a little bit too early on that, but definitely Kazuya is the embodiment of, you know, touch of death characters.
Oh, for sure. Like, in the same way that you have a fear of God, of Bayonetta and of, like, in Smash 4. Being specifically Smash 4. Like ICs and stuff like that. Obviously, to different extents, all of these characters, but they can touch of death you. That's the main point here. And certainly, Kazuya has that sort of touch of death, if not in a sideways fashion. That's going to be some big damage right there.
I mean, for sure. You definitely have to make sure you pray, but to not whatever deity you believe in, you got to make sure you pray to the House of 3000, because this is where you're going to catch this action right here.
Ooh,
only this.
Big back air, laser, still
look
enough.
At that.
That move does not kill. It takes a long time for that move to kill, even right by the blast zone. Up-B down
and up-B too. That's so crazy.
Yeah,
oh my god.
That move, the crazy thing about Kazuya up-B is it has a strong hitbox for the entire way through.
Yeah,
he's trying to kill him.
No, he literally ducked under that to go for the uppercut. That's so crazy.
We're probably back to stage here. It's going to be tough, though. All right, we're back.
Up throw.
Was just enough. Even on a character as heavy as Kazuya. Kazuya heavier than Piranha Plant. Super duper heavy character. We're going to be seeing Dark Blue's looking for this stock here. That's big damage though. 50% is a lot. Obviously, Kazuya can make that back, but this is scary.
That was very good, reaction on, you know, Salazar, because it's actually a very long time before Kazuya can actually jump when they're doing their jump animation. So that was very good on that part.
Yeah, you are stuck in Kazuya's jump animation for 15 frames, which is really tough to get back to stage in the situation. So if you have that recognition and know that, it can be really tough for you to get back to stage. Really tough here, though, for Dark Blues. Looking like Salazar doing an excellent job. I mean, Samus' strongest suit is her ledge trap game, and we're seeing how good Salazar has been at doing that. With those down Bs, with those neutral Bs, up tilting there a couple times. Really an excellent job there by Salazar at the ledge drop game. And Kazuya is a character that, despite having a reflector and things like that, can still struggle with projectile characters because of his jump being so bad and him being just not particularly fast. And kick out of stage. So that's one of those things. You can still struggle as a projectile character, or as Kazuya against projectile characters, despite like having the tools to beat them.
I mean, definitely, I feel like we might have needed to see a smaller stage there.
Yeah.
You know, for sure.
But we're back to stadium anyway. All right, interesting pick here. I mean, you like the smaller blast zone off the top. That's obviously incredibly helpful. But as Kazuya, you're killing characters with that uppy. You're killing characters with that up smash. Big damage.
Ooh, okay.
Big damage. And we've seen Dark Blue in these past couple of weeks really developing the Kazuya quite a bit. Has played a lot of characters throughout the span of this game. But the Kazuya has really come in strong here. That grab is huge, so I don't blame him for going for that grab there. We got Schmix. We got tether cancel Schmix. Mm-hmm. We like that.
And you know, the kind of thing about like kind of learning how to play new characters, when you have a character like Kazuya who's just has all these weaknesses, it forces you to learn how to really, really play, you know, advantage. Like, you wouldn't have the same, you know, kind of concept of advantage.
Oh, we got invincibility. On the grab! Said, that grab? No! We're crouch dashing through it and you're exploding!
Yes, but for sure, you wouldn't have the same, you know, concept of neutral as, like, a Palutena, per se, because you both have, you know, different ideas of what neutral is.
Yeah.
So just that alone is definitely showing us, you know, how good, you know, Dark Blues has been putting in a lot of work with this character.
Oh.
Just reading a whole bunch of options, but not gonna read that roll away into up throw, because that was going to spell D-E-A-T-H right there. Yeah.
And that was a really unfortunate miss on the initial combo there. Could have gotten some big damage. Big damage here. That charge shot is kind of a crazy combo starter in a lot of ways. The unfull charge shot has so much stun. Misses it there, but really close to true combo. Ooh, needed to do that throw a little bit sooner. Great mash by Celzar. However, juggle situation here. That is something that... We're dead.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah, that electric wing off fist. Probably the best combo starter move in the game. It's kind of crazy. And Dark Blues has been very good. But the advantage now in the corner is Dark Blues. And we've seen how good the ledge traps have been for Celzar. The reactions have been on point. And a quick edge guard gets that stock gone. And we're on final stock for both of these players.
I mean, we definitely need to be a little bit more character from Dark Blues, because their advantage was what gained them the lead. However, if you lose this, you know, idea of advantage that you had earlier, you can definitely see this game being a 2-0. And we don't want that, do we? We want to see all more of the action.
Yeah, and a missed electric wing got fish was costly there. We're dead. Yeah, we're dead. That is, I think, the jump didn't come out. And just didn't have enough room to get back to stage.
Well, listen now.
Kazuya Mishima wins, and we're going to go back. I think the jump just didn't come out. I don't think there was a wasted jump. Yeah, the jump just didn't come out.
Wait.
Or maybe just went too deep with the down air. That could have also been that. I didn't see a jump come out, but...
Yeah, no, their jump didn't come out for sure.
But yeah, with that said, moving on to this game number 3. Kind of fortunate there for Dark Blues. You take those. Still could have absolutely have won that game in a normal fashion. About even percents for both players. Mm-hmm. But you definitely take that. Takes a little bit of the stress off. Certainly puts some pressure onto Celzar. You never want to be in a situation. Jab grab, classic stuff from Samus. The jab kind of puts out a good spacing for her to go back to have a grab. Oh, just barely missing out a grab right there. The hitbox is being thrown out. It's such good placements here for Celzar. Kind of just really keeping Dark Blues in disadvantage. Has to get back to stage. Stalls with that. Air dodge down and just barely gets back. Ooh, but the ledge traps once again so good for Celzar. And it's so tough to get off against Bomb. But big down smash catches roll as well. 111 already for Celzar. This is really big. Huge damage already. Oh, let's go. We got fist. 20%.
Okay.
Okay. Misses not gonna get there. But 38's not bad as a start.
I mean, definitely we're just seeing here now.
Go for a haymaker.
For sure.
We're living.
Very nice, but not going to do too much. Oh, you saw how much damage that did.
Yeah, the command input version of that move does like 40%.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. That move is not okay. It has full like invincibility and full like armor. It has too much.
This character is on
crazy.
Crack.
Yeah, this character is wild. Oh, we're backstage. That's a huge roll. Great timing by Dark Blues there. Utilizing. Oh, the tools get back. Oh, F throw's there. Is Electric Wing Fist going to come out?
Kind of things that we're definitely seeing really well from Celzar is that, you know, Celzar has definitely been picking up on a lot of, you know, disadvantage options that Dark Blues tends to choose most of the time. And, you know, although, you know, Celzar has also been getting, you know, called out for the same things, it's just that, you know, Celzar has just been so much better in advantage. Yeah. They've been controlling almost all of these games, minus the last game, but...
But it's a big jump over back here. Mm-hmm. It's going to take the stock. And that puts Dark Blues into a pretty decent situation, all things considered, how that first stock was going. But yeah, that it's so much stun on shield, that charge shot, so much ability for combos as well. Gotta be so careful. This should be a nice little combo for Dark Blues. 44%, not bad at all. Definitely tough when there's a platform in the mix there for Kazuya to get like a full string. I can see why. And a huge placement right there. That was really good. Dark Blues not happy with himself there. But we're gonna see if there's the ability here to really get a big confirm. You can't be missing those crouch dashes there. Trying to get through all those Samus hitboxes can be really tough, especially if you are missing those crouch dashes. Misses the electric version. Doesn't get a full confirm.
So the thing that I kind of want to point...
That's a death! Ooh. Wow, that's huge.
So what we've been seeing is a lot of the crouch dashing inwards, but it doesn't help that much when you can when you can't actually, you know, get that same distance going backwards.
Yeah.
We're seeing a lot of times where Dark Blues will be trying to, you know, be very aggressive, but he doesn't know how to just step back a little bit before he actually, like, kind of throws in a little bit of mix when being aggressive. Yeah. So that's just that kind of something that, you know.
So tough to get back by Samus. Gosh, such great ledge traps. Big damage. We got a 61%.
Oh, wow.
That's big. Okay, that would have honestly maybe killed with full rage. So I cannot blame Duckless for going for that. But Electric Wind God Fist is always on the table here. Scary move. Dead. Gotta be a stock, though. That up throw is enough. Clutching it out right there is Celzar.
Okay.
Great work. Respect on both players.
The death. Y'all gotta make sure this is not no normal John Numbers fist bump. Y'all gotta dap him up. Listen, there's nothing but respect here for all of these players. Y'all can't be playing none of that mess.
But a great grab right there. A little bit of fist bump. We love it. It was a close game for sure. And yeah, that's going to be that. Our first game three that we've casted so far.
Mm-hmm.
And otherwise, you know, nice work by both players in that set. Very interesting. Really nice stock right there. The placement on that neutral B was really, really good by Celzar. But yeah, welcome back, everyone. I am Anel. I'm joined by Jazzy G.